We are at the church of Nicholas the Miracle Maker in Romashkova village, where several holy martyrs served, Nikolay Gavarin, Valentin Lukyanov, and Yelisey Stolder. Also, here, holy martyr Nikolay Dobronravov spent his early years.
Holy martyr Nikolay was born on the 21st of November in 1861 in the village of Ignatovka in Mitrovsky County in Moscow province, in the family of priest Pavel Dobronravov, who became a prior at the church of Nicholas the Miracle Maker in the village of Romashkovo, where Nikolay spent his childhood and youth. The sister of Nikolay Pavlovich, Olympiada, married Alexander Mikhailovich Vorontsov, who was ordained a priest at the Church of Nicholas the Miracle Maker in 1889, becoming its prior up to its closure in 1941. In 1881, Nikolay Pavlovich graduated from Moscow Spiritual Seminary and in 1885 graduated from Moscow Ecclesiastical Academy with a degree of candidate of theology and began to teach theology and Holy Writ in Bethany Spiritual Seminary. After his marriage, he was ordained a priest and in 1886 became a bachelor of theology, writing lots of articles and books on theological and ecclesiastical issues. Since 1890, Father Nikolay taught the Law of God in Alexander Military Academy in Moscow. Since 1892, Father Nikolay served at the Church of Holy Martyr Alexandra of Rome at Alexander Military Academy and taught the Law of God in different Moscow gymnasiums. In 1917, he served at the Church of Holy Martyr Nicetas in Staroye Tolmachi in Kuznetskaya Street. In 1917-1918, the priest was a member of local council of the Orthodox Church of Russia. After the revolution of 1917 and the closure of Alexander Military Academy, Father Nikolay was transferred to the Church of All Saints on Kulishki. In summer 1918, the authorities decided to arrest the priest. On the 19th of August, he was arrested and imprisoned in Lubyanka prison in Moscow. On the 3rd of December 1918, the Presidium of Extraordinary Commission sentenced Father Nikolay to the imprisonment in a labor camp. But the case was reviewed, and finally, on the 16th of April, it was decided that due to the lack of vivid evidence against the priest, he was given freedom. At the beginning of 1921, Archpriest Nikolay became a prior to the Cathedral of Domitian in Krutitskaya. By that time, he widowed and took monastic vows, being ordained a bishop of Zvenigorod, the vicar of Moscow diocese. In 1922, many archpriests who did not support the dissenters, the revolutionaries, were arrested. Among others, Bishop Nikolay was also arrested. The authorities sentenced him to 1 year of exile to Zyryan Krai. Upon his return to Moscow, Bishop Nikolay was ordained an archbishop. The church hierarch became one of fellow campaigners of Patriarch Tikhon, helping him in defending the church from the attacks of the revolutionaries. On the 16th of April 1924, the authorities arrested the archbishop and imprisoned him in Butyrskaya prison in Moscow. He was falsely accused of severe beating of workers and peasants inspectorate member, as well as of using his authority in counter-revolutionary agitation among clergy. Being questioned, Archbishop said that he was in charge of Zvenigorod diocese as well as the church in Zamoskvoretsky district in Moscow that included 3 rural deans districts with 44 churches. I have never held any special meeting with rural deans. There have not been held any anti-Soviet speeches of mine, as while communicating with rural deans, I have always stuck to the church sphere only. As for my preachers, they have concerned only moral sides of life. On the 14th of June 1924, the archbishop was given freedom. The same year he was appointed an archbishop of Vladimir and Suzdal. After the death of Patriarch Tikhon, Father Nikolay became one of the assistants of the patriarchal locum tenens Peter Polanski. On the 11th of November 1925, the authorities decided to accelerate the process of splitting in the church. So, for that purpose, they needed to arrest those archbishops who were against anti-church policy of the state. On the 11th, 20th, and 30th of November in 1925, 11 closest fellow campaigners of Metropolitan Peter, as well as Archbishop Nikolay and a lot of priests and laymen, were arrested. In prison, the investigator in vain tried to persuade the Archbishop to give false testifies against guiltless people. On the 21st of May in 1926, during the special meeting of OGPU, Archbishop Nikolay was sentenced to 3 years of exile in Siberia. When the period of exile ended, he was allowed to live everywhere except six big cities with a constant place of living for 3 years. When the period of deprival of civil rights ended, Archbishop Nikolay settled in Moscow. During the persecutions in 1937, the authorities made the extermination of clergymen their top priority. On the 27th of November, Father Nikolay was arrested and imprisoned in Butyrskaya prison. On the questioning, he was accused of taking part in counter-revolutionary organization of the clergymen. On the 7th of December in 1937, the NKVD Troika sentenced Father Nikolay to firing squad. Archbishop Nikolay Dobronravov was executed on the 10th of December in 1937 and was entombed in the unknown pauper's grave on the Butova Range area near Moscow. In August 2000, during the anniversary Bishops' Council, Archbishop Nikolay Dobronravov was canonized as new martyr and confessor of Russia.